My name is Dimitrija Mihajlova, and I will present you our paper called An Overview of Methods to Combat Eavesdropping in NOMA-based Networks Through Physical Layer Security. Here is the content of the presentation. Conventionally used orthogonal multiple access schemes share the available resources in time, frequency, code, or space domain in such a way that the signals received at different users are orthogonal to each other. Although orthogonality ensures interference mitigation, the limited transmission resources make the support of high data rates and low latency a challenge, especially in large-scale networks. To improve system throughput, NOMA can be employed instead as an effective multiple access that permits multiple users to transmit simultaneously on the same frequency band by means of superposition coding at the transmitter and successive interference cancellation at the receiver side. NOMA is envisioned as a key enabling technology for future radio access, which can provide efficient spectrum utilization and hence high data rate and low latency communications. Depending on the multiplexing employed, NOMA can be realized in either the code or power domain. Code domain NOMA allows each time frequency resource block to be exploited by multiple users by the assignment of spreading sequences with low mutual correlation. Power domain NOMA, on the other hand, shares the entire radio resource by allocating different transmit power levels to users in accordance with their channel gains. This paper is focused on power domain NOMA, which is referred to NOMA for the sake of brevity. However, the operation principles of NOMA impose new challenges for the privacy enhancement of information exchange. Attractive solutions to protect the NOMA network are the physical layer security methods, which provide information theoretic security from the random nature of wireless systems. In this paper, the physical layer security approaches that can be used to improve the security of downlink NOMA transmissions are investigated. The main principles of NOMA are based on user ordering according to their channel conditions. Depending on the channel gain, users in the pair are referred to as a near user and a far user, as it is shown in the figure. Power allocation is performed so as to serve the far user with higher transmit power. During downlink transmission, the base station performs superposition coding on the signals intended to both the users in the pair and broadcasts the resultant composite signal, which can be derived following equation 1. The signals received at both users in the pair are given in equation 2, and as higher power rate is allocated to the far user component of the composite signal, the intended signal at the far user is obtained by directly decoding the received signal. The far user treats the near user component of the composite signal as interference and ignores its presence. In order to decode its own signal, the new user has first to decode the far user component, considered as interference, and subtract it via successive interference cancellation from the received signal, as it is shown in equation 3. The residual signal after successive interference cancellation is then decoded to obtain the signal intended to the new user. Security concerns in NOMA networks are different than those in OMA networks due to the SIG algorithm employed. On the one hand, both users in the pair are able to decode the signals of each other, which is required for the proper operation of the successive interference cancellation algorithm. On the other hand, the broadcast nature of the downlink NOMA channel makes it vulnerable to eavesdropping outside the network. Therefore, normal downlink transmission is exposed to both external and internal eavesdropping attacks, and its security enhancement can be classified into the following three groups: security against external eavesdroppers, security against internal eavesdroppers, and security against both external and internal eavesdroppers. The internal eavesdropping can be additionally subdivided on two types depending on whether the untrusted user is the far one or the near one. In the case of an external eavesdropper, his location and channel state information are not available at the base station. Depending on the location of the eavesdropper in the cell, the amount of transmit power assigned to the legitimate users, different amounts of their signals can be obtained by the unauthorized user. The most common techniques used at the physical layer to mitigate the effect of external eavesdropping in normal-based networks include power allocation based on channel conditions of legitimate users. The second one is beamforming aimed in the direction of legitimate users. Artificial noise-aided beamforming to interfere with the eavesdropping signals and degrade their quality. And the fourth method is distributed beamforming by cooperative relays with or without cooperative jamming. According to the NOMO principle, the far user decodes the intended signal from the received superposed signal, treating the information of the new user as interference. Even with less power, the new user's signal component is still present in the composite received signal and can be partially decoded by the far user. This security problem can be solved by physical layer security techniques, and some of them are power allocation, beamforming, and artificial noise-aided beamforming. However, proper dimensioning of beamforming matrices is of significant importance so as to ensure the privacy of the near user signal while achieving the basic rate of the far user. In order to apply seek operations, the near user has first to decode the signal of the far user. Moreover, NOMO principles for power allocation additionally facilitate detection of far user's signal by the near user. Therefore, securing the far user's information from untrusted near user eavesdropping presents a main security concern in NOMO-based networks. Finding a solution to this problem is a very challenging task, since information leakage of the far user's signal has to be prevented while ensuring the normal operation of seek decoding. In literature, there is a limited number of studies in protecting the far user's data against eavesdropping at the near user. Several proposals to combat this security issue include a joint beamforming and power allocation algorithm, an angle conversion method to transform the original signals of users before transmission, in order to be secure the transformations for each user follow different principles, which can be learned by the intended user via an auxiliary mechanism. And another method is a directional modulation method, distorting the transmitted symbols at the near user so that to be from a lower order symbol alphabet. Despite the numerous advantages provided by NOMO, the essence of the applied successive interference cancellation algorithm makes the NOMO system vulnerable to different types of eavesdropping attacks. In this paper, three variated types of NOMO eavesdropping are examined, together with an overview of methods to combat them. To the best of the author's knowledge, there are only a few works focused on security against internal name is dropping on the far user by the new user. And the limited number of studies on this severe problem for the security of NOMA makes it an open research area that needs further comprehensive studies. Thank you for your attention.